Hello fellow YouTubers, it's me again, and I have a review today that I completely forgot about. Just like Mephiles, I can't believe I forgot this guy. I got him as, you know, a while ago, and I never reviewed him. Like, you know, I just totally glossed over it. Yeah, this guy, Ultraman Ace. I just completely forgot about him. I totally was going to, but, you know, just forgot. So, yeah, sorry about that. So, this is, we'll just get started. This is the new Ultraman Ace figure, not the the usual one from the regular Ultra Hero series. These ones, you know, they come in new packages, as you can see, and they don't come with tags. Now, you're probably, you know, wondering, well, okay, what's the difference between this Ace and the previous one? Well, this one just plain has a better sculpt. You may not know it right away, but if you compare the two, this one, it just looks better. Yeah, that's kind of the thing about the new Ultra Hero line, if you already know. You know, they come in these packages. They're pretty much all new molds for all the Ultra Heroes, even if it's tweaked slightly. And they just look better and nicer. Except for maybe the Ultraman Tiga, but, you know. So, yeah. This is the usual. It's the same like the Ultraman 80 box. Just got stuff about Ace on it. And got a clear plastic. It looks kind of cheap with the kind of background they have, but, what can you do? New packaging, better figure. No problem. So, yeah, same with the Ultraman Ace, or 80. You just undo these parts here, and I just leave the tape onto the bottom. Take them out like this, and there you go. There's Ultraman Ace. So, yeah, this is the latest version of Ace. Nice figure. Paint job, as you can see, he's silver and red, as with all Ultra Heroes. He is made of red vinyl, and painted silver with other various colors, and unlike Ultraman 80, he is not missing any paint detail on his color timer. As you can see there, there's silver around the color timer as there should be. I know some people on my Ultraman 80 review were saying, oh, you're too nitpicky, it doesn't matter, that's how it was. No, it's actually not. You can see for yourself on Ace. So yeah, as for, you know, just the detail of the sculpt figure, it's just great. It's obviously, much, like I said, much better than the previous Ace figure, and it just looks nice. I'll get to the detail in a second, but right now I'm going to go for scaling for the Ultra Heroes. You probably already seen Ace in my other videos, but here's, you know, him compared with a few other Ace Kaiju. Yeah, pool. The burrito. What an asshole. And Bakshin. He's got moving there. So yeah, just comparing with him with some Ace Kaiju. As you can see, he fits in scale well with, you know, the humanoid villains, Hipporito and Ace, or Yapul, but not, you know, Bakshin, obviously. But that's Bakshin's fault. So, yeah, he scales up pretty well with these guys. And, if you don't have those guys, here's just a basic Godzilla. I'm gonna show you. Ace is obviously taller than Godzilla, so it's a little off, but whatever, it doesn't really matter. It looks fine, you know, otherwise, if you have them teaming up or whatever. Looks good to me. So, scaling, you know, pretty typical of the Ultra Heroes. Articulation, obviously, arms and torso. No big deal there. It's just the basic Ultra Hero figure from Bandai, what can you expect? But it does look really nice. That's kind of the draw of these guys. They look really nice, even if they aren't, you know, very well made for to be, you know, they're not very poseable. They're not very good action figures, but whatever. Just basic stuff. So let's go to the detail. And here's the detail for Ultraman Ace. As you can see, he's got that kind of bug-eyed look. The color of his eyes is actually slightly darker and different than other Ultra Heroes, and that's actually how it is. He's got kind of like the weird ear shape, mouth shape, and little head fin with the little energy lamp beam thing. Yeah, it has a, you know, black filled-in for the hole, but, oh well, what can you do? So yeah, just good detail in this guy overall, like all the stripes on his body, very accurate. The fists, and the feet, the boots, they look more like boots now than they used to, so that looks good. Looks like he's actually wearing gloves and stuff, which is, you know, again, accurate. What can you say? It's Ultraman Ace. Looks great. You should all know the history for Ace now, or the basic history, that he is just an Ultra Hero. He obviously appeared in the TV show Ultraman Ace, and just fought a series of villains created by, you know, Yapul over here, you know, this guy. And eventually fought Yapul and various other alien beings along the series. I'm just gonna keep it really general because I don't want to get, you know, drag this out too long. He has obviously had cameos in other series, latest being the, Ultra Galaxy Legends, and I think one or two of the Guidance, I'm not sure. Most notably was in the, what you call it, Ghost Rebirth, I think, yeah. And he had a pretty significant role along with Taro to, you know, to fight, you know, Death Room and then Mephiles and all of them guys. So yeah, that's about Ace General, you know, the basic history, Ultra Hero. He had his own TV show, blah blah blah, has cameos, blah blah blah, classic character, yada yada yada. I think Ace is a little less popular than the others, but I don't know. I think Ace looks pretty cool. He was kind of the young brother at the time, and for all of you who don't know, he was actually an adopted son of a father of Ultra. So he and Taro are kind of like stepbrothers. So that means they have kind of, a kindred spirit about them. That really doesn't get explored too much in the TV show, unfortunately. But, yeah, that's about Ace's history. The figure is going to get, obviously, I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. The reason I'm giving it a 4 is because it's just such a nice sculpt, and it's an updated sculpt of the previous, you know, Ace figure. Paint job is nice and crisp, accurate. Scaling, obviously, not too big, but, just for a basic Ultra Hero suit, it's very nice for what it is. It's obviously not trying to be a Revolt Deck figure or anything, or Ultra Act, but for what it is, it's really nice. So pick it up if you're a fan of the Ultras, and you want to collect all the Ultra Brothers like I do, or someday at least. And if Ace is appealing to you, get him. Otherwise, you know, if you're not a fan of Ultraman, don't even know why you're even watching this review. So yeah, that's all I got up for you guys today. Hope you enjoyed the review, and I'll see you later.